Scotty was a great teammate, you know, an underrated player actually, but mostly a real good teammate and just a good guy to have on in your room.
Derek Keenan knows all too well what Scott McMichael meant to the lacrosse community. Teammates in the 1980s and Man Cup champions together. Keenan is now the head coach of the Redmen and carries some special memories of Scott along with him behind the bench.
Yeah, well, I'll tell you, he made every guy in our room feel a little bigger, that's for sure. But again, like just a tremendous teammate and a real good player. Like, you know, he had skill and he was obviously physical and tough and very good defender, but he could score too. He was a skilled guy and, you know, I think a little bit underrated part of his game, I think.
Rich Kilgore had countless battles with McMichael during his playing days with Six Nations and says the night in Scott's honor is well suited to be one that celebrates minor lacrosse.
Oh, for sure. I mean, every little kid who goes to a lacrosse game, if they ever saw Scott McMichael play, that's the right way to play. So he could teach a lot of little kids the right way to play. Everyone had to play both ends of the floor. And, you know, Scotty liked the D end a little bit more than the O end. But if he was open, you couldn't leave him open because he would be able to bang a goal here and there. So, you know, just utmost respect for the guy. And it was a real honor to play against him.
The McMichael name continues to live on not only during the annual minor lacrosse night, but the 2018 Redmen features Scott's son, Mitch.
The whole McMichael family, we're all extremely grateful to the Brooklyn Redmen for keeping this tradition going for all those years. You know, it's a really good night, and I'm just happy that I can be a part of it and actually playing the game. And, you know, it means a lot to us, and, you know, we're really appreciative of the organization for doing it.
Oh man, I can't help but smile when thinking back on Scotty. And you know, after the game, everything was dropped. He was just a class guy, and you know, we'd all head up to the beer gardens before we hopped on the bus, and he'd be the first guy to shake your hand and, you know, say it was a fun game and let you know that, you know, he just wanted to compete, and he competed at the highest level, and he brought the best out of you by, you know, making you be ready and play your hardest, because if you didn't play your hardest against Scott McMichael, you were in big trouble.